like the German Stahlhelm would, and the eventual design resembled the medieval kettle hat or chapelle de fer. It was a well-engineered solution to the problems of the trenches, featuring a bowl shape with a brim, constructed from steel pressed from a single sheet. This design was cheap and easy to produce and protected the head from nearby shrapnel explosions. However, unlike other helmets, the neck was left exposed. The first design, or the Type A, soon transformed into the Type B, which had a stronger steel content, a narrower brim, and a more domed crown, therefore offering even better protection. The weight of the Brodie helmet was 1.3 pounds, or 0.59 kilograms. The initial paint scheme was a camouflage of mottled light green, blue, and orange, or a solid overall coat of green or blue-gray. These early paint finishes were found to be too reflective, and the helmet was too shallow. So in 1916, a matte khaki textured paint, often mixed with sawdust or sand, was applied to the official finish. And in 1917, a cushioned liner was applied for better comfort. Soldiers could also apply an exterior sack cover that camouflaged the outer bowl. The helmet was introduced sparingly in 1915, with British soldiers borrowing them from the trench stores when it was their turn for the front line, but saw wide use by July 1916 as general issue, when 1 million helmets were produced. Soon, the Commonwealth forces would also be equipped with the Mark I helmet, and US forces, after initially purchasing them from Britain, would manufacture their own version, called the M1917.
Watch our other videos to learn more.